Hi guys, I know you see these designs on internet and you're like, how do they create them? So what you need to do is get a stone board. This board are sold in the market. There are different patterns. It depends on what you want to use them for. And there are also different colors of stone. So you can pick the one for your dress, for your abaya, for a shirt, for anything, any style you want to use it for danshiki, for both male and female. So now I'll teach you how to go about it. Shout out to all my subscribers. If you're new right here, click the subscribe button. You don't want to miss my video. So to start with, I'll be spreading the stone on my stone board. I'll be using this Odwa head. So you can see now that I put my stones, I just pour a little amount of stones and I'm spreading it with a foam. What I'm trying to do is that I am spreading it so that it will reduce the time at which I'm going to use arranging them. Okay, instead of just starting with just using my hands to just place it one after the other, there are holes, so the stones are filling up the space. So after spreading it all through the board, what I'll do is that I'll make sure that each stone enter those holes that you're looking at. You can see I spread them largely, then I need to be sure that they are into the hole, because some of them will actually fall out of place, so I can only use my hand. So you can see now I have set them one after the other, and every hole on the board has been filled for this particular head design. Interesting, right? I know you're wondering how it's going to be on the dress. That is why you're on the best YouTube channel. Everything is set. Check, check, check. Everything is set. So this is a transfer sheet that we're going to transfer the head design on before it gets to the dress. Yes, so this is sold in the market. I really can't say how it is sold, but I bought the whole pack. I can't really say the price, but it's something affordable and something you can easily get, trust me. So you cut out a little piece that will be large enough to accommodate the whole pattern you're transferring. So we are going to separate the transfer sheet, because there is a part that has what's it called, like a gummy part, and there is a sheet that you're going to place it to seal it back, just the way you see paper board yes in the market. So you're trying to create your own. So carefully you're going to detach the nylon, the transparent one, from the white one, as you can see. So the transparent one is the one that has the gum parts. You might need to get someone to assist you, because you can actually mess it up while trying to transfer it, okay? At this point, you need to be extra careful. So I got someone to assist me so that we can hit the target at once. I want all the stones to be on the transparent sheet so that I can transfer it properly. So make sure you hit your target at once and you put it on the board at once. Then you use something to just hold it down. A foam is fine. Then I went ahead, I even turned my board upside down because I want all the stones to be on the sheet before I lift it. So now I'm lifting it gently, and all my stones are on the sheet, so I don't need the board anymore. So I have all the stones attached to the transparent sheet. Yeah, so you can see what it looks like. So now it's not over. We need to, in case you're not transferring on your fabric immediately, you want to save it or you want to sell it, so you pick the white part that we removed and you fix it back just the way it was. The only difference is that there is stone in between, so what you arrange is now safe. You can use it any other time. You can use it in a year. You can sell it if you sell tailoring materials, and you can put it on your clothes. So to transfer it to the clothes, you need a stoning machine, heat transfer machine. So what you do is that you remove it again anytime you're ready to put it on your fabric. So that's the importance. You can always use it. You already saved it, so you can always use it anytime. So now you make sure that you place your dress and you
mark wherever you want the stone to be, so you don't want to design and make it look ugly. If you want to put it on the chest, you must have set it. If you want to put it on your waistline, you must have set it. So gently, you make sure that your stoning machine is hot at a particular temperature. It has a digital screen that you can always see what temperature it is. So what you do is that once it is hot, you close it so that the heat can transfer the gumming part of the stone to the dress and it stick to the dress. So you close it. I'm just going to do it now. Okay, so you close it. Might make a sound once it is hot. I think it's a setting, actually. It depends on how you set it. So once it is done, it makes a sound and I open it. So once I open it, everything is on the clothes. I remove the nylon. We don't need it. We already transferred it. It's called a transfer sheet. And we already, okay. So if you notice that it's not properly done, you close it again. And you do it to make it stick very well. So now I'm removing the nylon because all the stones have been transferred to the fabric. Yeah, so it's secured, it's safe, and also I'm going to close it. You know, I just want to be double sure, so I closed it for the last time and it's fine. So now it's all on the fabric and it's so beautiful. You can see it's not gonna remove, nah. So it's blink. So you can go ahead and also blink your dresses, your abaya. You know, stones come in different colors and you can just use any color that you want. So let me show you another one that I made. Okay, so you can follow me on Tolex Afrik Fashion Academy. And if
you enjoyed this video, there are many more that you're going to learn from, so turn on your notification, subscribe if you are yet to do so, and please like, share, comment. This will help a lot of people to see my video. I want a lot of people to learn from this channel. Thank you.